The set is an important tool in Python, and today we're going to talk about it. And a set in Python is simply an unordered collection of elements with no duplicates. And this unordered and no duplication, these are important clauses. The sets used by Python are just a programmatic version of the sets used by mathematicians. So let's talk a bit about set theory. Let's say we have a basket of fruit. And I don't know, let's say it contains 5 apples, 3 oranges, and 2 tomatoes. These, I suppose, would be the apples or maybe the tomatoes, but we don't have to worry about that. If we want to represent this as a set, we wouldn't care about this quantity, so the fact that there's 5 apples doesn't matter. In fact, I could just write apple, orange, and tomato, and label this set fruit. The elements of this set, fruit, are simply the entries apple, orange, and tomato. Now, let's say we also have a set called vegetable, and some of the elements in this set would be broccoli, carrot, and tomato. When I was coming up with this question, there was some heated debate in the office about whether tomatoes are fruits or vegetables, so let's just include it in both. That means that when I draw the circle that encompasses this set, it actually has an overlap with the set fruit. And in set theory, this overlap is called the intersection. And I'm going to mention these set theory terms, but you don't have to worry about them too much. This diagram I've drawn here is known in set theory as a Venn diagram. And they can be very useful for visualizing what's going on with sets. Now, here comes the interesting part. We can create new sets by taking subsections or performing operations on these sets. For example, if we want to know what elements are fruits and vegetables, which, like I said before, is called the intersection, we could write fruit, ampersand, vegetable, and we could see the only element would be tomato. I should point out that this symbol and the other symbols I will be using are not what we usually use in mathematical set theory, but since they're what we use in Python, I'm going to be sticking with this convention. We could also ask what elements are fruits but not vegetables, which is known as the set difference. And the only elements that are fruits but not vegetables are apple and orange. We could ask which elements are fruits or vegetables. And here I've used the vertical line to indicate that. And this would give us all of these entries. All of these entries are either a fruit or a vegetable or both. The last operation I'm going to talk about is asking which elements are fruits or vegetables, but not both. And this is known as the symmetric difference. And here we've used the caret to indicate that, which is not the same as this caret. And this is just all of the entries except for tomato.